Winning streak before you lost to Florida. You played well against Auburn and then the Arkansas game. Why has it been tough to sustain this kind of success?
I think lack of focus during the game. We get low, so we'll get a lead and get content, not keeping our intensity consistently. We didn't follow the game plan all the way through against Arkansas, and we got upset due to that reason.
The players mentioned that the practice prior to the game, practices had not been that good. How did they bounce back from the practices after the loss?
Yeah, we didn't have the best preparation leaving. We didn't do what we were supposed to do, and in turn, we got beat. But after the loss, we came back. We had a 7 a.m. practice. It was an opportunity to get better, not just a punishment, opportunity to get better. We knew that we had underachieved, did not go to Arkansas and do what we were supposed to do. So now we're moving forward, getting ready to for Notre Dame.
When was the 7 a.m. one, Friday or Saturday?
Friday.
Boy, that's an early practice after a late. I mean, well, you probably landed like early Friday morning. They got to go to class anyway, so.
Yeah, we're back in school, so it's back to business. Go to practice, go to class, get them back in the routine. But we thought it was important while it was fresh on their mind to go back, work on the things that we did not do well. We turned the ball over 24 times. We didn't shoot the ball great. We ignited their offense by turning the ball over, gave them easy scoring opportunities, and it's hard to win on the road when you play that way.
So when did you arrive back on campus, and how soon after was it that you practiced then?
We arrived back the normal time. I mean, we usually get in around midnight.
Okay.
Midnight, and then we practice the next morning.
7 a.m. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Did you handle the scout for Notre Dame?
I did.
What are the challenges that Notre Dame is going to present tomorrow night?
Well, they're probably the most high-powered offense that we have faced thus far. They average 82 points. They have five people on the floor. They can score at all times. They have unbelievable shooters in Cable and both Mabrys. So they score very well. They execute very well. They take what the offense gives them. They play well. They average 18 assists per game. So we have to stay disciplined defensively.
What do you sense the confidence level of y'all's team is at right now?
I think we're back on track. I think they're very focused. They've been focused since we've been back. They know we're going into a hostile environment, a team that we lost to a year ago. So they know what it takes to win. I thought they went ahead and watched the edit early before we watched film today as a team. So that's always a good sign that they're invested and ready to go.
Kyra, this team's been up and down, and things are being said outside of the program. What would you tell those
things
fans?
Things are being said?
True. Maybe you don't pay attention, but what would you tell those fans to keep the faith, keep confident in what we're doing, here at UT with this team, with this program, but, they're still seeing.
Well, obviously the fans were disappointed that we lost,
sure.
and we are disappointed as well. We have a responsibility to uphold a legacy and play the Lady Ball way, which we did not on Thursday night against Arkansas, but I think we have shown that we have greatness. So I would just tell the fans, stay patient. We will get back on track. We have a lot of talent. It's just a matter of clicking at the right time, getting everyone playing at a high level at the same time. But we'll get back on track. We'll do some great things this week. Every team has peaks and valleys at different points in time. We just happened to hit a low point on Thursday, and we just told the girls Monday we can be right back on a high.
Do you think they're looking forward to the stage? Because there's no bigger opportunity than Big Monday at Notre Dame, ESPN2.
Well, they came here to play on the big stage, so they have the opportunity to do so on Monday. We will be focused, ready to go. We'll lay it out there, and that's what we tell our kids. Be focused, lay your heart and soul out there, and the best team will win.
Kyra, there's some encouragement, may not be the right word, but when you're losing, it's because you're not playing well at all. I mean, it's not like you're playing outstanding and then you're losing the game. Is that frustrating and also encouraging that you could see how much better this team can be?
Well, the good thing is the season is long. I know for the fans right now, it seems like it's over. It's not over. A long year. We have a lot of talent. We can get better each and every day. We're trying to progress. Obviously, we're not shooting the ball well right now. We're getting them in, getting extra shots, really watching a lot of film to show them what they're doing during the game. But our challenge for them is to play as hard as you can consistently for 40 minutes, not 24, not 23, but for 40. And then I think you will see a vast improvement.
This team, to some extent, goes as Diamond goes. They sort of get in her slipstream. When she's struggling, it can almost be a domino effect. How can you help Diamond get settled down? And when, because she can look outstanding one game, and then obviously she was pretty distraught about the turnovers against Arkansas. Any way to sort of help her get into a better groove?
Well, one, it's not all about Diamond. So we have several players. So Bashar is a go-to player. Mercedes is a go-to player. That's the beauty of having a lot of talent. Obviously, Diamond is extremely talented, but we just talked to her about taking good shots, taking easy shots. She doesn't have to make the home run play. She will cut down on her turnovers, which she was very upset about. But we just challenged her to get your teammates involved, play hard defensively, and good things will come.